Hey everyone, what's going on? This is Curbbender here. Today I'm coming at you with a settings video for the Logitech G923 steering wheel on Assetto Corsa using Content Manager and the Logitech G HUB. Once you got Content Manager and the Logitech G HUB installed, go ahead and open up your Logitech G HUB, and with your wheel plugged in and turned on, it should be registered right here in the main menu. You can click on it and go into the main wheel settings. You can see here I'm on the default option with 900 degrees of rotation, and you want to make sure apply settings from game is checked off. With the pedal sensitivity, I just keep these on default as well. Once you got that set up, you can go ahead and open up Content Manager. There's a ton of settings in here, so what I'm going to want you to do is go to the top right corner and go ahead and click on Settings. Next, you're going to want to look in the top left corner, and there's four more options up here. We're going to be working under the Assetto Corsa tab. You go down the drop down menu into the main controls menu, and here you'll find all the controls for your wheel. When you set it up at default, nothing's going to be mapped out. It'll start out on keyboard and mouse. You want to go ahead and hit this drop down and click on wheel. Starts you off in axis, so you're going to need to put in all your inputs. You just click the area and then move your wheel, and it should register your wheel here. Same with the throttle, brakes, clutch, and your handbrake. If these are orange like this, it means that they want to be inverted, so you can just test out your inputs. That's how the throttle should work. For the buttons, same thing, just click in, assign the shifter you want, previous gear. On these paddle shifters, use H shifter, click first gear, put your shifter in the first gear. Put your shifter in the second gear for the second one, and so forth for the other gears as well. Other important ones are like headlights. Go ahead and click in here, assign a button on your wheel. I like to use the horn, beeping people a lot. Moving on to system, big important one here is teleport to pits. Make sure you assign it to an easy location, like right here on my steering wheel. Patch, these are just some more extra buttons, like hazards, turn signals, and things like wipers if you need them for a rain patch. Moving on to the main force feedback tab. On default, this is how it should be set up. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you my racing profile. Nothing fancy here. I just have the gain turned down to about 36%. I'd say anywhere from 30 to 40%. Is a good starting position. For racing, I have the filter turned all the way up to 30%. 30 to 35% is what I would recommend. And that allows the computer to steer the car for you a little bit. And it gives you a little bit of play, so your car is not bouncing all over the highway at high speeds. With the minimum force, I got it down to 3%. It gives it a nice easy bump for when the car's ready to react. Just starting off, I have all these effects just turned off. It's an easy starting point, gets you focused on driving, and there's no distractions from the road and slipping and the brakes. And so, again, with post-processing, I have this turned off as well, and there's nothing else on either. Lastly, I look at the lower speeds force feedback reduction, and I do like to turn this up that way at low speeds. With a high power car, it's not shaking the wheel wire and moving really slow. So I just put this on about 1%, and you can bring this all the way up to max if you want to. Once you got your force feedback settings set up, you want to go ahead and save your profile. We're working on the default profile here, so just go ahead and hit save preset. And this is going to be our first racing profile, so I'm just going to type in racing profile number one. Then you just go ahead and save it, and your nursing profile should be saved right here. Every time you want to come back to these settings, you just click on it in the controls menu. So next I'm going to show you my little drift setup that I got here. It's a little bit different than the racing setup. So I keep the gain up at about 100%. It says 99, but okay, 100%. I keep the filter down at 0 for the drifting. That way all your raw inputs matter. There's no funky steering done by the computer. On the drifting, you want it to be nice and clean. Only inputs by you. For the minimum force, I just turn that a little bit up. It gives it a little stiffer kick on the drifting. Again, for the beginning, for beginner's sake, I just turn all these road effects off and the ABS off. Nothing going on with the post-processing, and you can do the same thing again and lower the low speeds, force feedback reduction, down to like 1%. And that'll be a good drift setup for you to get started. These aren't professional settings by any means, but they got me started, and I think it's a good drifting and racing profile setup. Here you can see it once again. Here's my race setup at about 36, 31 filter, minimum force at 3, and the drift setup, I got the gain up at 100, filter totally off, and the minimum force just a little bit higher. Everything else is the same. I have all the effects turned off, and it should be good to go at that point. Main thing is you want to learn how to work these profiles and just save them. It's pretty simple. Once you do it a couple times, you might have to go in here and delete a bad profile if you save it, but no biggie, you know, they're right there. All right, so once you got your profile set up, I want to show you guys one last thing. I always go into here, into the drive menu, and once you're in the single, this is going to be your main car settings. So this is like stock game with no mods. I just chose a Lamborghini on the Highlands track. I'm getting ready to drive here, you know, so you're going to want to look at these. These are my car profiles, and what you're going to do is click this little, I don't know why there isn't like a better option to see it, but you're going to want to click these three buttons here, and it opens up your traction control, your ABS, and your stability control. And so you can see I have this one labeled as drift, and I have the stability control completely off. I have the ABS completely off, traction control. I don't have any options on for drift, so it's completely raw input and just no steering assist or help going on. For the racing profile, I always use this Pro one. I should probably label these better, but so what I do is I just leave some traction control on. I got ABS on and stability control up at 100%. I think that really helps with the supercars and stuff like that at high speeds. Still getting used to the wheel and everything, so I'm not a pro yet. I don't turn all these completely off unless you want to have a little fun, do some burnouts. You can go ahead and turn them off and see what you want to do. But so every time that I'm on the online menu, and I'll go into the highway racing, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go in and set on the race setting, and then I'm gonna go into drive and hit single and make sure I'm on my race setting as well, so I'm confident that I have my traction control and stability control. I'm not 100% sure if it affects all the online lobbies, but you know, I like to make sure that this profile is set up for when I get on here as well. And then so when you go into like a drifting lobby, let's see if I can find one. Yeah, so if I was going into this drifting lobby, I would come back here, hit the drift setting real quick, go back into drive, go back into single, and then I'll make sure I was on the drift profile so that I have no traction control, no ABS, and then I'm just going to go into the online and it should be good to go. Alright, so we're just going to get in here and I'm going to show you the very last setting, and this is an easy on-the-fly setting for once you get into each lobby. It's a little different for drifting and for racing, but it's pretty easy to remember. So what I do is get in here, you can see. There we go. Oh jeez, it's loud. Alright, yeah, so I got the drift profile on. And what I'm gonna do is up here on my main keyboard, there's the plus and minus buttons near the plus and minus buttons near the number pad, and you want to adjust this force feedback. You see how it's at the top of the screen there, it's telling you how much percentage you're kicking into your force feedback. That can be super important in learning how to drift. So when I started, I think I would turn this way down to a really low level. It makes the wheel really soft, and it makes it so that it doesn't jerk around on you too much. And then, so here we are going back into a highway racing lobby. Just going to make sure I'm on, going back on the race profile. Gonna go back into drive for the single, and I'm going to make sure I'm on my race profile again. And we're going to go into online, and I'll show you the in-game force feedback adjustment I do on this one. Okay, so here we are in online lobby for the highway racing, or just any racing in general. Since we turned that gain way down to 30 to 40%, the steering wheel is going to feel really loose on here. So what I like to do is I just crank the in-game force feedback up to about 200%. That feels a little loose still. I like to go up to like 250, maybe even 300 if you want to. So yeah, so those are my settings. Yeah, so those are my settings. Let me know if this video helped you out. Got the drift profile and the race profile. I think I got everything covered in there. If I missed something, please drop a comment below. If there's something else you want me to go into detail, like installing mods or something in the future, we can do that too. Just let me know and we'll see. So, peace out. Have a good one. This is Kurt Fender. Thanks for watching.